First time in a princess's chamber, my friend. We return to find that my father is finally doing something about the Coven threat. But it's not enough. Extra patrols and rounding up the Harrow is all well and good. But what we really need is a defense against the Harrow storms. Unfortunately, we've only recovered a few of the medallions. And Magister Fridelia hasn't determined what enchantment the medallions use to provide their protection. We need another solution. Right. Lyris mentioned that. Coincidentally, a courier delivered a message for you from Dusktown. I never heard of the place, but she said it was sent by someone named Fenorian. Is that your scholar? Read the message and let's see if he'll help us. Take the message from the table, then see if you can convince Fenorian to join us. Maybe with his help we can devise a defense against the storms. I'll stay here and continue to annoy my father until he gives this threat the attention it deserves. You forget that I have help now. My father might be able to ignore me, but he'll have a harder time dismissing a Jarl and a court mage. It's funny. I would have thought he'd be happy to see me finally take an interest in politics. I don't care about his approval, but I'd like to earn his respect. With Mother gone, we're both going to have to work harder to keep our kingdom running. It will be easier if we find a way to get along.
Dusktown. I wonder what Fenn's found that led him back down there. Does his message give any indication of where we can find him? The settlement isn't big, but it's not exactly small either. Well, it's a start. You know, I never imagined I'd be working alongside a vampire, let alone one I respect. With all the leeches we've already had to kill, it's nice to see another side. Fenn's different. You go on ahead. I need to get my axe sharpened before I go back down into Blackreach. I'll catch up with you in Dusktown.
Watch your back.
What an exciting case! I simply must write down this new development.
We focus on the task.
Those new arrivals, they didn't stop in Dusktown, went straight for those dwarven ruins.
Hey, partner. Glad I found you. Now let's get Fennin. Hey, partner. Glad I found you. Now let's get Fennin returned to the Blue Palace. Fenn, you in here? Let's look around. Fenn never struck me as a messy person. Could there have been a struggle here? Burnt papers. Someone was trying to hide something. Burnt journal pages, Fenn's flask, and a strange old key. All found among clear signs of a struggle. But other than what's in the flask, we didn't see any blood. That means Fenn was probably taken alive. The key looks dwarven to me, and the notes mention a dwarven tower. They could be connected. The notes also indicate that Fenn was going to meet with someone named Edyar east of the Dusktown Bridge. You start there, and I'll check with the locals. We have no idea who Edyar is, or who took Fenn for that matter. It could be this Ashen Lord we heard mentioned, or maybe the Ice Reach Coven. The question is, why take Fenn at all? Why not just kill him? Does he have information they need? More than likely. If they want to get information out of him, death might be preferable to whatever tortures they have planned. Let's get to it. You find this Edyar, and I'll see if the locals saw what happened here.
Sarloff, this is my patch of ground. You don't listen too well, do you? All right. Talk fast and tell me why I shouldn't rip out your throat. The silk shirt kept notes? Of course he did. And where is Fenorian? He's late, and he still hasn't compensated me for the information I gave him. I need that key! Missing? Probably taken by the same bastard that has my packmates, Exarch Zingales. Fenorian said he could provide a key to unlock their chains, if I told him about the experiments performed on us. If you can get that key, I'll tell you more. Hercene's fetid breath, that's it! Look, I managed to escape from Zingales' tower, but my packmates are still chained up in the Lightless Hollow. Use that key to set them free. then I'll tell you how to find Fenorian. The Lightless Hollow lies to the east, and... Hercene's claws? Who is that tall woman?
Stand down. I'm a friend.
My packmates are in a work camp on the Lightless Hollow's west side. That's the big cavern to the east. You need that key to unlock the special chains that bind them. I'll meet you south of the work camp after you set them free.
None of the locals really wanted to talk. One or two admitted to seeing Fen, but no one witnessed any kind of disturbance at his lodgings. At least, no one saw anything they were willing to tell me about. Is this Edyar? Does he know anything? Why is everything so complicated in this part of Skyrim? All right, so tell me, what did Fen agree to do for our half-naked friend over there? Packmates? Edyar is a werewolf? This just keeps getting better and better. So I take it you know how you want to deal with this particular situation?
Nothing.
You don't smell like the Grey Host. Run before they catch you too. You set me free? I owe you one.
Bastards! Perseid's claws. I thought I'd be digging forever. Thanks.
We should not linger, Edyar. The Grey Host could find us at any moment.
Head to the surface. I need to fulfill my end of our bargain. You actually did it. You freed my pack. Now it's my turn. If Exarch Zingales took Fenorian, and I'm pretty sure he did, you'll find them both in the ruined Dwarven Tower. It's difficult to get inside if you're not a vampire, but I know a way. Like I said, Zingales's helper made a mistake. Forgot to fasten my chains after one of my tortures. I slipped away, crawled along some pipes, and fell into a chamber with one of those dwarven lifts. There was also a door, the one behind me. It'll get you close. There's a big door that leads into Zingales's lair, but it's sealed. You'd need to figure out the dwarven mechanism to open it. Then make your way to the experimentation chamber. That's probably where he's keeping Fenorian. The door's over here. Hurry, before they spot us.
Definitely dwarven. Watch out for traps. That must be the door Edyar mentioned. Sealed tight. No lock. Not even a handle. I don't suppose the werewolf told you how to open it, did he? The panels are all different. I wonder what they mean. Gear started moving. You must be doing something right. try the door. This chamber's been used recently. Let's look around. Must be the nether root mentioned in the note. Why does everything connected to vampires involve blood?
The Ice Reach Coven's magic is cruel but effective.
That was Fen. We need to keep moving.
It fights against its nature, Rada Al-Saran. A weaker breed.
No, Zingus.
That smell. It's overpowering. We need to shut down those machines. They're spraying it on those plants. Let's get more of that nether root. Turn off those sprayers or we'll never get across this chamber. Chamber. Sure as bones, that stone husk is moving.
Ah!
Why are you doing this to me?
Momentarily, my lord.
Finish your work here, Sigalis, and join me in the keep. You must bear witness when we make our move.
Of course, Radha Al-Saran. I am eager to see the power of our ultimate power storm. You test subjects just in time. This one is about spent. You will do well in my machine. Ashamed. I cannot wait.
It's too late for me.
Fence Delirious. See if you can free him.
Go. Solitude. You should have left me. Go warn Solitude. Aksak Singalis and Radha Al-Saran talked freely while they tortured me. They're planning some sort of assault on Solitude. A massive Harrow Storm. I need blood. But I won't drink from an unwilling person. In this state, even with a willing participant, I don't trust my restraint. If I only had my flask. My flask! Thank you, my friend. Radha Al-Saran is the one they call the Ashen Lord, leader of the Grey Host. He and Singalis often went into the nearby sanctum to talk. I heard a few words. Map. Plan. But I couldn't make out the rest. Yes. Yes. Once I take a long drink from my flask, I'll join you.
Take your time. You've been through a lot.
They did whatever they wanted. I couldn't stop them. Aksak Singalis was insane. But he was also a genius. But if he kept records, they'll be in here.
I see a map. And some papers. Hey, partner, take a look. So, partner, what did you find?
We set out to find Fenn and bring him back to Solitude. Along the way, we learned more about our true enemy, killed one of their leaders, and acquired some valuable intelligence. That's a victory in my book. Not that I can think of. I'll make sure that Fenn makes it to the Blue Palace. We'll meet you there. And don't forget that map and communique. Come on, Fenn. Princess Vana herself requested your presence at the Blue Palace.
I don't believe I'm very good company.
Come on, Fenn.
storm and shine across land or sea.
Wolf attacks? Ghosts? Reachman raids? I'm getting out of this town.
It's true. The Reach attacked Morthal. The Jarl's soldiers put a stop to it, as I understand it.
You are welcome here, Fenorian of House Ravenwatch.
I don't know what to say.
You're back! Lyris was just making introductions and was about to give her report. Why don't you tell me what happened? By all the Mead and Sovngarde, it's good to see you and the others. Your vampire scholar seems out of sorts, but I'm glad to make his acquaintance. Lyris tells me you ran into a bit of trouble. Care to explain? And I can't wait to hear all the details. In the meantime, let's take a look at what you found and try to devise a plan. Lyris didn't say much, but she indicated that time is short. Here, take this. You deserve a lot more, but it's all I can spare. The information you brought...
My father wrote that, so I will.